got things going on in this country, in this world, right here in this city. And here we are debating plastic bags, 5 cents on plastic bags. I mean, it's a shame that we have to put a committee meeting together like this.
Trying to find the logic in this, Senator Marty Golden joined your voice against the 5 cent bag tax. Thanks for joining us. I'm Julia Lilkendy.
Thank you, Julia.
How are you today? Thank you very much.
Very good. And yourself?
Pretty good.
Thank you.
New York City is set to, in October, add a bag tax for merchandise bags. Explain this.
Well, you got to be careful of the terminology. See, they can't pass a tax unless they come to the state legislature. So what they did is passed on a fee that will go to the business owner or to the retailer, a nickel on every plastic bag. And, of course, the pretense to that is to reduce the different impacts that we have in our landfills around the city and making sure we reduce the plastic bags because it takes so many years they'd never get broken down. So they're saying it's about 2%. I don't think it's that high at all. And to give the fee, 5 cent fee, which is a run around the state legislature so that they could they wouldn't get away passing a tax. We wouldn't allow it up here. As a matter of fact, we got a bill that's going to stop it, we hope, and reverse it. But they give it to the retailer. They don't give it to an EPA project, an environmental project. They don't bring any resources into the city or to the state. It just makes no good sense to go after. This is not just plastic bags. This is paper bags. Mm-hmm. So you can't get a paper bag or a plastic bag. And they're going to allow you to buy bags or go in with these cloth bags. And you're going to have chicken in there, chopped meat, vegetables. And, you know, you take it home. The people going to wash these bags? No. So you got a cross-contamination issue. And then I listened to one of the city council people that presented testimony, and he says, well, if it doesn't work in 6 months, we'll change it. We'll make some changes to it. And he says, trust me. I says, that's what you're going to tell the people of the city of New York? Trust me? 8.5 million people, trust me? Are you really kidding me that you're going to change it? You shouldn't have done it in the first place. So you did it, you can't be trusted to change it and to stop it. So we in the state hope to do that.
Right. So this is going to, you know, really impact a lot of people and certain people in specifically. Let's take a look at you asking questions about that.
Those that are within SNAP that have to that pay cash will be charged. Those just above it will unfortunately be charged this tax. Can I afford this tax? No. I mean, you go to a store today, you can have 10, 15 bags. And you add that up over the course of a period of a year, you're talking about a significant impact to a small family. And that's just one tax, Commissioner. That's just one tax. You don't put that on top of our gasoline taxes, our water taxes, our real estate taxes, our small business taxes, taxes on Tide, taxes on everything. We are one of the highest taxed cities in the nation. And we just can't keep going down this route. It's just plain wrong. Commissioner, I'm going to let you respond to that. If you wish to.
No, I mean, I understand your perception that it is a tax. It's not a tax. It is a fee.
Commissioner, I love you. It's a tax. Go ahead.
But we do have over 132 cities and counties in this country who have imposed fees or bans. There are a lot of towns in New York State that have imposed bans on plastic bags. There are over 18 countries that have done it, and everyone has seen significant reductions in waste. And so, I mean, that is really why we are trying to mimic some of those laws to make sure that we really drive down the use, because the idea is not that you pay. The concept here is we really want you to bring a reusable bag and not pay. As you know, the people who are on SNAP or on WIC are exempt.
If they're paying cash, they're not exempt. If they're using the SNAP card, they are.
Right, or if they
bring
their SNAP card.
But what about those people that are right above that level? What about those poor people just above that level?
One of my challenges with this is just philosophical. I don't know why we think that poor people can't remember a reusable bag and wealthy people can.
Go on.
Well, I believe that if you go into communities, there are people that are using that, both people that are not substantial and people that are substantial. So that argument is a false argument. I think the commissioner is a good commissioner. I think she really means well, but this is the wrong way to go about it. There were other ways they could have went about this, but they chose to do it this way. It's an impact, whichever they want to. There's no way of getting around this. This is, a tax is a tax is a tax. They did a fancy word called fee to get around tax, but this is an impact to every store. Every person that lives in our city is going to have to adhere to this very, very shortly. Let me tell you, just the store alone, what the nightmare is going to be to do the paperwork. They only work on a 2% markup as it is. So you're going to have them in there doing selling these bags and trying to make sure there's no plastic bags going out, and they're getting the 5 cents from each person for that plastic bag, which means they're going to service those bags in their stores, which means that it's going to be a problem, correct? They don't get it. They just don't get it. So we have an impact coming down, and I don't think they really thought out the consequences. Communities of color are going to be impacted. Our seniors will be impacted, and our families across the city, substantial, and those that are not in the upper tiers of financial income, they will suffer the most.
Right. So they really said this is for the environment, and as you mentioned, you know, no money is going into the environment. Do you believe that's really the reason?
It might be, but if it might be well-intentioned, but I think it's everything that's going on in this world and everything that's going on in the city, everything I said in that tape there, this is the highest taxed city in the country. And all we keep on doing, we just did $15 minimum wage, which is going to impact the city of New York, the small business. We're going to wind up laying people off, closing businesses, and now we're putting another fee for bags. So what's next? They just can't find enough resources and enough issues that are impacting our communities, and they shouldn't. They shouldn't be doing this. They should be looking at education, transportation, hospitals. They should be looking at our policing and helping to get more money into our policing and get better legislation passed. Those are the things the city council should be looking at, not at these issues that they're looking at today.
Mm-hmm. So you mentioned that there's legislation in the Senate and the Assembly to make sure this doesn't go through?
Correct. We got to see how that, I believe we'll get it passed in the Senate. We just got to hope the Assembly passes it, because it makes no good sense to get this bill and not be on it and not to vote for it. I'd love to see the Assembly person that doesn't vote for this, or the state senator that doesn't vote for this.
I know. So as you mentioned, this impacts senior citizens. And you, you used to chair aging for so long, and you have a really good relationship with the seniors in your community and a good system of making sure you reach out and hear from them. Recently, you had a luncheon for senior citizens and also provided some resources so they could go around and ask questions about any concerns that they may have.
Well, they are actually, I got to be one of the largest graying communities in our state. If you take a look at the aging population here in the state of New York and the counties of Kings and Queens, they're the two of the largest counties in the country when it comes to aging. Florida obviously is moving up and has the numbers across the state in Florida. But if you look at counties, we are Brooklyn, Kings County, and Queens County are the top two counties. So if you got an aging community coming in, what you have to do is you have to keep them informed and you got to keep them involved. People want to be involved. They want to be at events and meet with other seniors and have that dialogue going on. That's why we have senior centers, but only about 15% of the people go to these senior centers. So that senior is isolated, right? May have lost their loved one, may have their kids are moved away into different cities and states and not nearby. So we need to get them out, get them to join themselves, and they get a nice lunch. And on top of that, you have all the different city and state agencies and federal agencies. So if you've got an issue with Social Security, we got people that work with you. If you have a problem with Medicaid or Medicare, we have people that work with you. If there is an issue with the transportation or with public safety, they're there. They're there to turn around and walk you through the process, whether it's SOFA or the aging department in the city of New York City Aging. They're there to turn around and help them. And I think that's what's important. And of course, everybody's worried about water taxes in the city of New York. We just finished up taxes again, and real estate taxes. So we have the Department of Finance that sits there too as well and meets and greets with the seniors. So I do a couple of them around the community. And this particular one you were looking at was in St. Patrick's. We're over in a couple of the other parishes in our community, and we got a 300 seniors came to that event, and they were well informed when they left, and they had a good time.
golden.mysenate.gov for the next one. So a few weeks ago, we did an entire program on mayoral control, and there was another hearing in New York City. Mayor de Blasio didn't show up, and I was wondering, how did you take that?
Well, it's not so much as I've taken it, is that there is a, whether people want to admit it or not, there is obviously a back and forth between the governor and the mayor of the city of New York, and it's not working out well. And of course, my colleagues in the Senate are not actually very happy with them either. So it's very difficult when you don't give us the opportunity to question you, especially, you know, this is one of his signature issues is education. So he came and he was very good up here when he came and testified. I mean, he answered every question and he didn't dance. He didn't come back with the answers that we wanted from, that's why I think they wanted him at this one at 250 Broadway in New York City, so that the questions that were proposed at the hearing here could have been answered down there. So I think he did himself a little disservice here by not being there. So Carmen Farina did a great job representing the mayor of the city of New York, but at the end of the day, the Senate body wanted to see the mayor and wanted those questions, you know, asked and answered, but real answers this time. So I think he's got a real issue here coming up, mayoral control. I know that the Assembly has passed a bill that would give him 3 years of mayoral control. 3 years, right? And I think the Senate is between 0 years and 1 year, and I'm not sure where we're going to go over the next several weeks. I do believe, though, as a senator from New York City, that he owns it. You know, if the commissioner is the police department, he's got the commissioner. If it's the transportation, it's his commissioner. If it's buildings, it's his commissioner. So it should be the same with schools. So I believe that he should have the overview and the actual administration of the Department of Education in the city of New York. So let's see what happens.
Yeah, one point you have been bringing up is just how it's alarming that you can't figure out where the money is going. And during the hearing, you brought up a solution. Let's take a look at that.
If you could bring one of our kids in from the schools, they can build a better tech program so we can easily access that program so we can break it down by district, by school, by account, what money is going into that school, what programs they have. I think we got some of the best kids in the entire country going to our schools. So
I believe there's
no reason for this not to happen. This is the 21st century. We should do that.
So you seem to love the idea.
Well, I tell you, it makes sense, and I think not only in our school, they got pointed out a seventh grader as the conversation went on.
Wow.
And believe me, if you looked at their website, you would be shocked. I got very web, internet-friendly staff. You can't track. You got to be, a Harvard graduate to try to get through this web page, and you still don't get to the answer that you want to get to. So I think you have to simplify it. I think the chancellor understood that. And, there's a whole host of issues about funding, about the capital money, where it goes, how it got spent, how's the money for pre-K, how'd this money get, we have actual, loans out on against this money. How'd they do that? You know, how could you possibly take capital money and move it into the operating cost? And why does it take so long to get a school built? And why do so many overruns in these schools? That should all be laid out. And that's, I think, with some of the issues that my colleagues had. You got to remember, we gave them fantastic money. It's the largest budget that we've ever done in the city of New York for education, $25 million. They got $9 billion out of that. That's the largest ever in the history for the state and for the city of New York. So we just want to make sure, I guess my colleagues want to make sure that the money is being spent wisely and being put to use efficiently.
Okay, so we are out of time, but next week let's talk about heroin legislation, because this is a developing situation we've been talking about, and veterans.
You got it.
All right. Thanks, Senator.
Thank you.
And thank you for watching Your Voice with Senator Marty Golden. For additional information on what we discussed today, golden.nysenate.gov.